I've been asked to compare Elixir and Go for a long time, and in this video, I'll compare it with the Go standard library. I even received a pull request with implementation. So if you want me to test your favorite framework, just raise a PR. In the first test, as always, we'll measure latency from the client side using P99 percentile. We'll measure throughput by counting requests per second, CPU usage of the container running in Kubernetes, as well as the memory usage. We'll also measure availability or error rate. Since I'm running these two applications in Kubernetes, we need to measure CPU throttling as well. The second test is a bit more realistic and definitely more interesting. This is the first time I've used a large enough EC2 instance for the database, so it doesn't become a bottleneck. I'll explain design later, but we'll instrument each application with Prometheus metric. We'll measure how long it takes to insert a new record for each app, as well as overall post request duration. Additionally, we'll measure CPU usage of the database and the connection pool size created by each application. I use AWS to run all my benchmarks. For the applications, I use M7A large instances. I use 4 extra large Graviton instances to deploy my monitoring components like Prometheus and Grafana, and I also use this to deploy clients that generate load. For the second test, I used specialized 2 extra large instances to run the database. The best part about these instances is that you don't need to pay extra for the disk usage. It's included in the EC2 price. This instance type comes with 2 SSD disks offering 2.5 terabytes of storage each. It's ideal for self-managed distributed databases like Cassandra, Kafka, and even Postgres. To support my channel and pay for the infrastructure, I'd like to offer one-on-one sessions. You can find more information about this in the video description. For the first test, I created a VPC and all networking components from scratch using Terraform. I also set up EKS cluster with 2 instance groups. The first group has 2 M7A large nodes, each with 2 CPUs and 8 GB of memory, where I deploy only my applications. So each node runs exactly one application. I set the resource limits to match VM capacity, ensuring no noisy neighbors. For the monitoring, I use a second instance group based on Graviton instances to deploy Prometheus, Grafana, and run clients to generate load using Kubernetes jobs. So when an app gets a GET request, it sends back hard-coded devices to the client. For the second test, I created a database on 2 extra large instances with 8 CPUs and 64 GB of memory. I used PGTune to optimize Postgres configuration for this hardware and set the connection limit to 1050, which is pretty high but necessary for this test. Each time the app receives a request, it parses the JSON payload, generates UUID and timestamp, inserts the record into the database, and returns ID generated by Postgres to the client. Alright, let's go ahead and run the first test. The first and I think the most important metric to pay attention is latency. It directly affects user experience. In our case, we're using P99 percentile. You can think of it as 99% of all requests completing within the time range shown on the graph, and lower is of course better. The values are shown in microseconds, and when they reach 1000 microseconds, Grafana automatically converts them to milliseconds, and so on. From the start, Go performed much better than Elixir, and this trend pretty much continues till the end. On the right-hand side, we have throughput measured in requests per second. Throughput impacts the amount of resources you would need to support your application, directly affecting infrastructure costs. If you're on a tight budget, you would prefer application that can handle more requests with the same compute resources. Then we have saturation. First is the CPU usage measured for each container in Kubernetes using CAdvisor as well as memory usage. And you can see that Go also performs better in both cases. At around 18,000 requests per second, you can notice that Elixir is not able to handle any more requests and falling behind Go application. In Kubernetes, you always need to measure throttling since it directly affects application performance. In a few minutes, its availability also drops, indicating that many requests to Elixir app are either timing out or simply failing with 500 status codes. In this test, Elixir reaches its limit much faster than Go. I would say that this particular Elixir framework would be better compared with Python Django or even Ruby on Rails. Its performance is in the same category, maybe a little better. Alright, let's run it for a few more minutes, until Go application also reaches its limit. I run all my tests for around 1.5 hours and just speed up in the video when editing. Alright, Go app reached over 60,000 requests per second, which is very similar to all other benchmarks. In this one, I used third-party JSON library that performs better, leading to better overall performance for the Go application. You would also always notice memory spikes in Go applications when they can't handle any more requests. Alright, let me open each graph for the entire test duration. First, we have requests per second. In this graph, you can see a significant difference in performance. Elixir reached around 18,000 requests per second and Go around 60,000 requests per second. Next, we have latency measured from the client side, and again, you can see a huge difference here as well. Then we have CPU usage. To be honest, this is the reason. Higher CPU usage always leads to higher latency and lower throughput. Elixir app might use more middleware, or some libraries are not as efficient as Go libraries. Next, we have availability, which is the ratio of successful requests divided by the total number of requests. So a drop in availability means more clients get status codes in 400s and 500s. Then we have memory usage. This time, based on the feedback I received, I decided to use actual usage measured in bytes rather than using a percentage based on the total memory capacity of the VM. Let me know if I should change it back or keep it. And finally, we have CPU throttling. When you define pod limits that are translated to cgroups specs, if the container attempts to use more than its limit, cgroups will throttle it. This always causes a drop in performance, so it's important to monitor. This metric is critical when you're trying to configure your application for production. For example, determining how many threads should run per application or how many processes. Alright, time for the second test. This time I used a large enough VM for the database to handle all the requests from the applications without becoming a bottleneck. It's very common for one of your application's dependencies to become a bottleneck, like Redis, a database, or another microservice. So it's important to monitor not just your application, but everything around it. In this test, I added database latency, which indicates how long it takes for each application to insert a new record into the database. I instrumented each application internally with Prometheus metrics. We also have latency for the entire POST request measured from the client side using identical histogram buckets, allowing for direct comparison. Additionally, I measure Postgres CPU usage, and for this test, I used the latest 17.2 version. Whenever you have a database or a cache, you almost always use a connection pool, because establishing a new connection each time you interact with your database is expensive and slow. In both cases, I limited the number of connections to 500. This might seem like a huge number, but it's necessary for the load I generate. Otherwise, database again becomes a bottleneck. The difference here is that Elixir immediately creates all the connections, but Go application slowly adds more and more connections to the pool based on the load until it reaches the limit. At around 9,000 requests per second, Elixir reaches almost full CPU usage and can't handle any more requests. That would be the maximum it can process. Based on the Go application's CPU usage, it can double the throughput of Elixir's app. So let's go ahead and run it for a few more minutes. the Go app was able to reach almost 25,000 requests per second. This is the highest number across all the tests I've run in the past, simply because in all other tests, the database was a bottleneck. It's quite expensive to use 4 extra large instances all the time. Let me open each graph for the entire duration. This test took around 1.5 hours to run. First, we have requests per second. The difference here is again significant. Next, we have post-request latency. Also, let's take a look at the beginning of the test. Next is the database latency. Here's the CPU usage graph. Then, availability graph. Connection pool size. And finally, memory usage. So, once again, if you can improve any of the applications, please send me a pull request. If it makes a difference, I'll rerun the test and explain to others how to improve the performance of your favorite application. I have other benchmarks on my channel that you might find interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.